Joining us now, Dr. Robert Murphy, a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning.
Hey, good morning, Dan.
Well, these numbers obviously moving in the wrong direction here, but let's start with that potential good news out of South Africa, those metrics.
That's more than potential. That's real data. So they went from 127,000 cases a week to 90,000. I mean, my goodness, that's really quite dramatic in a one-week period of time. Now, got to remember, it's a younger population. This is their summer, so they're more outside there. Great place to go in January, by the way. And they had very strict mitigations. They had mask mandates everywhere. And they had social distancing mandates and limited crowd size, and that was nationwide. So, you know, they have a bunch of things going in their direction, but this is still good news.
It seems like there's more good news out of South Africa in terms of the J&J booster shot. It was showing that 85% protection from hospitalization against Omicron. Do you expect to see that have a resurgence here? I know it's gotten somewhat of a bad rap in terms of the potential for blood clots.
Yeah, no, this is actually really great news with for the J&J vaccine. You know, it's a very easy to manufacture and move around. It's got the problem with the blood clots, particularly in women under 50. But the efficacy rate that they showed, that you just said, the statistics look very good.
And let's talk about the potential for a booster shot for teenagers ages 12 to 15. Could that be a game changer?
Yeah, that's another game changer. Because there is a huge difference between two shots and three shots. These vaccines need to be three shots, these Moderna and Pfizer. I mean, that's clear. And it doesn't matter whether you're a kid or an adult or whatever, the three shot works so much better. In the adults, the mortality rate of COVID is 90% less, three shots versus two shots.
I also wanted to ask you about this Walter Reed Hospital developing what appears to be a new vaccine that might cover all of the variants. I know that's pretty early in development, though, I imagine.
Yeah, it's very early in development, but it's also really good news. You know, because there's been so much emphasis on vaccines, there's a huge amount of research going in, and this mRNA technology is all brand new, but other technologies as well. And I think it's very promising, but like as you said, it's early.
So I saw this tweet on Twitter a few days ago from Dr. Ashish Jha, and he said the CDC should have included a negative antigen test to end isolation. They didn't. Now some are justifying that decision by throwing antigen tests under the bus. Please don't do that. I wanted to get your thoughts on that statement.
Yeah, no, there's been a lot of communication about this. There's a lot of disagreement in the medical field to get rid of the antigen test. But there's a couple reasons. One is that the reason why they got rid of that testing, from what I can just gather, is that, you know, a lot of people and a lot of governors of states that aren't taking this seriously enough. I mean, they're not following any of these guidelines anyway. Two, of course, the tests were short supply. And we do know scientifically that viral load, that infectiousness, goes way down after 7 to 10 days. Why they're letting people out at 5 days, I don't know. That's really seems to be the thing. But, you know, you could debate 5 days, 7 days, 10 days. They're also saying, of course, wear a mask when you come out, but don't bother to do the test. The other little crimp in here is that the rapid tests do not work as good with Omicron. So the efficacy of the test drops. But you put all that together, they said, don't bother. But, you know, not everybody agrees.
All right, let's take a question here. This person writes, my two sons and I have COVID. My husband is negative. We'll come out of isolation a few days apart from each other. Can the first one out be around those two still in isolation and my COVID negative husband?
Yes. It's a little bit complicated, but the first one that comes out of isolation, I think it's the mother, she can be around the other two. She's done, she's protected. She's not going to be spreading it to them, and she's not going to be getting anything from them. She should be wearing a mask, however, but they're protected. So you can put the COVID people together, even if they're a couple days apart in their isolation, for one thing. And then after she's done with her isolation, she can even be around the husband, but with a mask.
With numbers and cases supposedly rising along with hospitalizations, why are people getting treated prior to getting hospitalized? And why are people getting treatment for COVID immediately when the person has been deemed positive?
Yeah, this is a great question. This is actually really the question of the day. Why are we treating everybody so early when they're feeling well? Well, you know, at the beginning of this whole thing, when we had remdesivir, we made all the treatments late. And guess what? They didn't work. Then when you look at the virology, remember I just said at the beginning, 2 days before you get symptoms, and then 2 or 3 days after you have symptoms is when you have the most virus. If you treat then, that lowers the whole viral burden in your body and you have a positive effect. You don't go to the hospital. You don't get severely ill. So it was counterintuitive from the beginning, but you know, we learn by doing the research, and that's why we do research. So what this is going to evolve to is test and treat. These pills are coming out any day, maybe even today, who knows? I mean, they got approved and they have them. So, you know, you're gonna get tested. And then if you're in one of those high risk groups, and you can define that in numerous different ways, you begin the treatment like right when you get diagnosed.
Gotcha. All right, Dr. Murphy, thank you.
Thanks, Dr. Murphy. If you didn't get your question answered by Dr. Murphy, he answers them biweekly on Northwestern University's Institute for Global Health Facebook page. You can also submit questions via email or head to our Morning News Facebook page and post one there. We will talk to Dr. Murphy again on Monday. Have a great weekend, Dr. Murphy.
And Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.